the Messiah enters Jerusalem. As Jesus moved off toward Jerusalem, people spread their cloaks in the road. And now as he was approaching the downward slope of the Mount of Olives, the whole group of disciples joyfully began to praise God at the top of their voices for all of the miracles that they had seen. They cried out, "Blessings on the King who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest heavens."
Prepare ye the way of the Lord. Prepare ye the way of the Lord. Prepare ye the way of the Lord. Prepare ye the way of the
Judas betrays Jesus. The feast of the unleavened bread, called the Passover, was now drawing near, and the chief priests and the scribes were looking for some way of doing away with Jesus because they mistrusted the people. And then Satan entered into Judas, surnamed Iscariot, who was numbered among the 12. He went to the chief priest and the officers of the guard to discuss a scheme for handing Jesus over to them. They were delighted and agreed to give him money. He accepted and looked for an opportunity to betray Jesus to them without the people knowing. The Last Supper. When the hour came, Jesus took his place at table with the apostles. He said to them, "I have eagerly desired to eat this Passover with you before I suffer. For I tell you, I shall not eat it again until there is fulfillment in the kingdom of God." And then he took bread, said the blessing, broke it and gave it to them, saying, "This is my body, which will be given for you. Do this in memory of me." And likewise the cup, after they had eaten, he took a cup, gave thanks, and said, "Take this and share it among yourselves. For I tell you that from this time on, I shall not drink of the fruit of the vine until the kingdom of God comes. This cup is the new covenant in my blood, which will be shed for you." And yet, behold, the hand of the one who is to betray me is with me on the table. For the Son of Man indeed goes as it has been determined, but woe to that man by whom he is betrayed. And they began to debate among themselves who among them would do such a deed. Simon, Simon, behold, Satan has determined to sift all of you like wheat, but I have prayed that your own faith may not fail. And once you have turned back, you must strengthen your brothers. Peter said to him, Lord, I am prepared to go to prison and to die with you. But Jesus replied, I tell you, Peter, before the cock crows this day, you will deny three times that you know me. And then, going out, he went, as was his custom, to the Mount of Olives, and the disciples followed him. When he arrived at the place, he said to them, Pray that you may not undergo the test. After withdrawing about a stone's throw from them and kneeling, he prayed, saying, Father, if you are willing, take this cup away from me. Still, not my will, but yours be done. And to strengthen him, an angel from heaven appeared to him. He was in such agony, and he prayed so fervently that his sweat became like drops of blood falling on the ground. When he arose from prayer and returned to his disciples, he found them sleeping from grief, and he said to them, Are you sleeping? Get up and pray that you may not undergo the test. And while he was still speaking, a crowd approached, and in front was one of the 12, a man named Judas. He went up to Jesus to kiss him, and Jesus said to him, Judas, are you betraying the Son of Man with a kiss? His disciples realized what was about to happen, and they asked, Lord, shall we strike with a sword? And one of them struck the high priest's servant and cut off his ear. But Jesus said to him in reply, Stop! No more of this. And then he touched the servant's ear, and he healed him. And Jesus said to the chief priests and temple guards and elders who had come for him, Have you come out against a robber with swords and clubs? Day after day I was with you in the temple area, and you did not seize me. But this is your hour, the time for the power of darkness. Jesus on trial. They led Jesus away to the high priest, and all the chief priests and elders and scribes came together. The chief priests and the entire Sanhedrin kept trying to obtain testimony against Jesus in order to put him to death, but they found none. Many gave false witnesses against him, but their testimony did not agree. Some took the stand and testified falsely against him, alleging, We heard him say, I will destroy this temple made with hands, and within 3 days I will build another not made with hands. Even so, their testimony did not agree. The high priest rose before the assembly and questioned Jesus, saying, Have you no answer? What are these men testifying against you? But he was silent and answered nothing. And again the high priest asked him and said, Are you the Christ, the Son of the Blessed One? And then Jesus answered, I am. And you will see the Son of Man seated at the right hand of the power and coming with the clouds of heaven. At that, the high priest tore his garments and said, "What further need have we of witnesses? You have heard the testimony. What do you think?" And they all condemned him as deserving to die. Some began to spit on him. They blindfolded him, and they struck him and said, "Prophesy." And the guards greeted him with blows. Peter denies Jesus. After arresting him, they led him away and took him to the house of the high priest. Peter was following at a distance. They lit a fire in the middle of the courtyard and sat around it, and Peter sat down with them. When a maid saw him seated in the light, she looked intently at him and said, "This man too was with him." But he denied it, saying, "Women, I do not know him." A short while later, someone else saw him and said, "You too were one of them." But Peter answered, "My friend, I am not." About an hour later, still another insisted, "Assuredly, this man too was with him, for he is also a Galilean." But Peter said, "My friend, I do not know what you're talking about." And just as he was saying this, the cock crowed. And the Lord turned and looked at Peter. And Peter remembered the words of the Lord, how he had said to him, "Before the cock crows today, you will deny me three times." He went out, and he began to weep bitterly. Now the men who held Jesus in custody were ridiculing him and beating him. They blindfolded him and questioned him, saying, "Prophesy, who is it that struck you?" And they reviled him and saying many other things against him. Jesus before the Sanhedrin. When day came, the council of elders of the people met, both chief priests and scribes, and they brought Jesus before their Sanhedrin. They said, "If you are the Christ, tell us." But he replied to them, "If I tell you, you will not believe. And if I question, you will not respond. But from this day on, the Son of Man will be seated at the right hand of the power of God." And they all ask, "Are you then the Son of God?" He replied to them, "You say that I am." And then they said, "What further need have we for testimony? We have heard it from his own mouth." Jesus before Pilate. Then the whole assembly of them arose and brought him before Pilate. They brought charges against him, saying, "We found this man misleading our people. He opposes the payment of taxes to Caesar and maintains that he is the Christ, a king." And Pilate asked him, "Are you the king of the Jews?" He said to him in reply, "You say so." And then Pilate addressed the crowds and the chief priests and said, "I find this man not guilty." But they were adamant and said, "He's inciting the people with his teaching throughout all of Judea, from Galilee where he began, even to here." On hearing this, Pilate asked if the man was a Galilean. And upon learning that he was under Herod's jurisdiction, he sent him to Herod, who was in Jerusalem at that time. Jesus before Herod. Herod was very, very glad to see Jesus, He'd been wanting to see him for a long time, for he had heard about him and had been hoping to see him perform some sign. Herod questioned Jesus at length, but Jesus gave him no answer. The chief priest and the scribes, meanwhile, stood by accusing him harshly. Herod and his soldiers treated him with contempt, and they mocked him. And after clothing him in a resplendent garb, sent him back to Pilate. Herod and Pilate became friends that very day, even though they had been enemies formerly. Jesus before Pilate again. Then Pilate summoned the chief priest and the rulers and the people, and he said to them, "You brought this man to me and accused him of inciting the people to revolt. I have conducted my investigation in your presence and have not found this man guilty of the charges you have brought against him. Nor did Herod, for he sent him back to us. So, no capital crime has been committed by him. Therefore, I shall have him flogged and then release him." But altogether they shouted out, "Away with this man! Release Barabbas to us!" Now Barabbas had been in prison for a rebellion that had taken place in the city and for murder. Again Pilate addressed them, still wishing to release Jesus. But they continued their shouting, "Crucify him! Crucify him!" And Pilate addressed them a third time, "What evil has this man done? I found him guilty of no capital crime. Therefore, I shall have him flogged and then release him." With loud cries, however, they persisted in calling for his execution, and their voices prevailed. The verdict of Pilate was that their demand should be granted. So he released the man who had been imprisoned for rebellion and murder, for whom they asked, and he handed Jesus over to them to deal with them as they wished. Jesus is crucified. Now two others, both criminals, were led away with them to be executed. When they came to the place of the skull, they crucified Jesus and the criminals there, one on his right and the other on his left. Now, one of the criminals hanging there reviled Jesus, saying, "Are you not the Christ? Save yourself and us." The other, however, rebuking him, said in reply, "Have you no fear of God, for you are subject to the same condemnation? And indeed, we have been condemned justly, for the sentence we receive corresponds to our crimes. But this man has done nothing criminal." And then he said to Jesus, "Remember me when you come into your kingdom." And Jesus replied, "Amen, I say to you, today you will be with me in paradise." And then Jesus said, "Father, forgive them. They know not what they do." It was now about noon, and darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m. Then the veil of the temple was torn down the middle, and Jesus cried out in a loud voice, "Father, it is finished. Into your hands I commend my spirit." And when he had said this, he breathed his last.
Sometimes it causes me to tremble. Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Were you there when they nailed him to the tree? Were you there when they nailed him to the tree? Oh, sometimes it causes me to tremble. Were you there when they nailed him to the tree? Were you there when they pierced him in the side? Were you there when they pierced him in the side? Oh, sometimes it causes me to tremble. Were you there when they pierced him in the side? Were you there when the sun refused to shine? Were you there when the sun refused to shine? Oh, sometimes it causes me to tremble. Were you there when the sun refused to shine? Were you there when they laid him in the tomb? Were you there when they laid him in the tomb? Oh, sometimes it causes me to tremble. Were you there when they laid him in the tomb?
Now there was a virtuous and righteous man named Joseph, who, though he was a member of the council, had not consented to their plan of action. He came from the Jewish town of Arimathea and was awaiting the kingdom of God. He went to Pilate and asked for the body of Jesus. After he had taken the body down and wrapped it in a linen cloth and laid him in a rock-hewn tomb in which no one else had yet been buried. It was the day of preparation, and the Sabbath was about to begin. The woman who had come from Galilee with them followed behind, and when they had seen the tomb and the way in which his body was laid in it, they returned and prepared spices and perfumed oils. Then they rested on the Sabbath according to the commandment. The Gospel of the Lord. Thank you all. The actors will be coming back in here just so that you can appreciate them, okay?